tester.co.uk.
Hello YouTubers and welcome to this T4D. Now you will have to excuse me a little bit. I have unfortunately again got a little bit of a head cold, so unfortunately I'm going to sound a little bit off key. But I just want to at last bring you the kind of big news I have been talking about for a little while, which I haven't been able to reveal until all the kind of T's have been crossed and the I's have been dotted. But before I get into that piece of news, it's been probably over a week since I've actually sat in front of the camera. Now, as you'll have known, you've had at least 3 videos in this past week. And what I did was, just over a week and a half ago, I kind of worked really hard and produced several videos, pre-uploaded them to YouTube, so I could release them slowly over the next few weeks, to buy myself some time, because I desperately needed to get into some admin stuff, which you'll understand once I kind of reveal the news. So it has afforded me the luxury to kind of concentrate on that admin stuff and complete my electronic DC load, which is actually busy working behind me, doing energy measurements on supercapacitors, hybrid capacitors, and different battery technologies. But that I'll go into in another T4D. So let me get down to then what this T4D is all about and the news which has been happening. So I'll go into more detail, but basically what we're doing is myself and the family are relocating to the States, or back to the States. Now when I say back to the States, if you've been following me long enough, you'll know that we were based in Cleveland, Ohio between 2008 and 2010. So we've lived in the States for 2.5 years. And that was because my wife, through her company, went on a secondment there. And she held a global role, which she actually brought back. She's continued to do that global role from South Africa. So it's certainly a big adventure and a big step. There are many reasons for why it happened, and I'll explain also in the title you've seen about the kind of bit about a banter over a beer. How this all kind of came about, there's kind of lots of bits and pieces which contribute to a move like this. Part of it is just sheer adventure, but you can't solely base your move, uprooting your family back to another country, just on adventure. There are some obviously real good reasons for why we are taking this big step. But anyway, I'll tell you how it all started out. Dean, my good friend Dean and I, we cycled twice. Well, he's cycling far more because he's training for a big race called the Cape Epic. I cycle with him twice a week, and on one of those days we'll go off to the pub and have a drink and a meal. And while we were chatting and having a bit of banter, so it's an English term for a bit of joking back and forth, the topic came up. Dean started talking about Colorado in the States, and he said, "Martin, have you ever seen Colorado or footage of Colorado?" And I said, "I haven't been there, but I have seen footage of Colorado," and I said, "It's absolutely stunning. I know it is." I said, "And it's the one place that I would seriously consider going back to the States to live in." And he said, "Really?" He said, "Heavens, if you're in Colorado, I'd definitely come over and cycle, because it's just stunning. The scenery there, the winters are stunning there as well." So that conversation kind of got me seriously thinking, and I came back home and I whispered in my wife's ear, and I know my wife has always been keen to kind of go back and pursue her career, because she also has enjoyed living in the States. We both love South Africa, but she's also enjoyed living in the States. So I whispered it in her ear that night when I got home, and literally the next day she kind of woke up and said, "Were you being serious?" And I said, "Yeah, no, I'm up for the adventure." And anyway, that was back in November, and she went on a business trip. And it progressed during December to like just before Christmas, where her company came back and said, "Yeah, we're up to doing this. We're willing to relocate you guys back to the States. We'd be happy to have you here." And the actual formal contract and everything was signed and agreed last week. So we will be going back to Cleveland, Ohio, because that's where my wife's business is based, and we've lived there before, so it's a very easy transition for us. And we'll be there certainly for the medium term, for quite a few years to come, but I'm going to use that opportunity and the time to kind of travel around the states, go and see Colorado, go and see places like New Hampshire. I know, because I know so many of you now in the states, and I communicate with you, I certainly plan to come actually visit and see that neck of the woods, because I want to discover more about the states and see where the nice places are to possibly live, bring up a family. So case in point, coming back to the reasons for that move, besides just a whole adventure idea, there are certain challenges with living in South Africa at the moment. It's Cape Town, South Africa, must be one of the most beautiful cities in the world. And if you go onto my Vlog Mag channel and have a look at like the, I've got where I go cycling or where I've taken footage of Dean's AC Cobras on top of Signal Hill, that isn't even a small part of the beauty that's contained here. I've lived and worked in several places around the world, and Cape Town still just holds a very, very special feel. I originally come from the UK, so I mean, I've worked in the UK and I've got family in the UK, but there's certainly something special about here. So my heart will always be here, but there are certainly challenges when you're even doing, and particularly doing the work I'm doing and raising a young daughter in this country at the moment. I won't have to elaborate to those of you who are based in South Africa. You'll know what I'm talking about. And so for the future of the family and my channel, it's right now, it's just going to be better being based in the States. And in terms of the channel, things like the cost of equipment, having a good, reliable postal, quick postal system in the States makes a huge difference in terms of me being able to get my hands on bits and pieces to play with, to discover. So, and also just bandwidth. Internet bandwidth is a challenge here, and it takes me a long time to upload videos. Often I've got two internet lines with a special router to give me failover in case a line fails, so it fails over to another line, so at least I can get my videos up. So those kinds of challenges are certainly eased to a large extent in the States. It doesn't mean that the States is the land of milk and honey. The United States has loads of challenges it has to face at the moment. I think there are loads of places around the world which have challenges to face. But right now, I think for us, that's where it's going to be a good place. And certainly for the long term, because you can't just up and root your family back and forth. So we certainly, the States, for the definitely for the foreseeable future, is going to be our home. And to that point, I know I have the viewership in South Africa. My South African viewership has grown immensely over the last year. And I've certainly have had, whether it's comments on YouTube or emails, saying, wow, we're so chuffed and so proud that, you know, we've got a South African video blogger who's doing what you're doing. And to them, I certainly say, I certainly hope you don't see this as something that I'm upping and deserting what I've done here. I originally actually started doing video blogging in the States, but South Africa is where it's really taken off. And I'll always come back and visit South Africa because a lot of my immediate family are here and friends. But I certainly do thank my South African audience and hope you'll obviously continue to follow what I do when I'm based in the States, because I just think it's, again, it's going to broaden the options in terms of what I can do with the channel. Now, to that end, there's also a nice flip side, and that is setting up my lab again. So here I'm going to ask you to actually help me. That's going to be one of the challenges, actually setting up a lab again in the States. And here I'm going to bring in the new sponsor I've got in terms of tester.co.uk. And when I mention and talk about tester.co.uk, it's just not merely just because I'm trying to promote them and because they are sponsoring the channel. At this point in time, I certainly have been very happy with the response and the way Barry has been working with me. I love the range of equipment they've got. I've actually seen holes in the range of equipment they've got, and Barry has openly said he's keen to fill those gaps, even if it means buying solar power equipment as well, other test equipment, electronic test equipment, which he doesn't have, And that's where your feedback is very handy as well. So it'll be interesting to see if Barry has a good ear, within reason obviously, but to make business sense, to make his business better to the customer. I'm intrigued to know whether, if you do use his services, that you do get good service, because if you don't, I'm the first one who's going to be concerned about it, because I don't want to be seen to be promoting a company that can't provide good service and good value to the customer. So that's what I intend to see and hopefully grow for tesla.co.uk. But in that regard, I would ask you, if you have any idea about the test equipment that perhaps you would love to have in your own lab, but perhaps either can't afford or would like to see tested before you actually buy it, here's an opportunity to go and spec out a brand new lab with whether it's measurement equipment or kit that I don't already have. Go and have a look at tesla.co.uk at the range of equipment they've got. Highlight the items that you think I should have in my lab in the States. If they don't have a piece of equipment, say, Martin, this is what I think you should have, but they don't have it, and that is something we can bring to Barry's attention. And then what will happen is, when I end up in the States, I will then, obviously, from the bits and pieces that you've selected, order those from tesla.co.uk and have them shipped over to the States and start building a new lab. And that's where you can be a part of that. To that end also, there is going to be equipment that tesla.co.uk can't supply. I also plan to start looking at older equipment on eBay. So just like I've got my older HP Scientific multimeter here, I also want to have a look at the older equipment and see if there's any good value in that. So that is something I'll also be adding to once I get to the States. So a lot of adventure ahead. And in this week and a half that I've actually not been in front of the camera, there's a lot that's happened news-wise in terms of what's going on with Fluke and the fake leads. There's a very interesting video I'm going to pose on that. I've had some new equipment arrive from Frankie. Comptest, the Fluke agents here, have brought me some interesting equipment. So I'm going to follow up with quite a few videos soon of reviews and the bits and pieces of news that's going on. So there's a fair amount that's going to happen. But anyway, I thank you very much for your support today. It certainly is appreciated, and I certainly hope you'll back me in this big new adventure that's going to be happening. That's only about 3 months left before we depart. So we will be departing in about mid-May. So 3 months left to kind of sort out the house, sort out packing up the house, and all the paraphernalia that goes with that, sorting out visas and everything. So there's a fair bit that's going to happen. So I will also, in the meantime, sometimes do a few videos ahead of time to buy me some time to kind of deal with all those life bits and pieces. And then when I go, I imagine there's going to be about a month, about from the end of April to May, end of May, when we pack up here, fly over, and then unpack on the other side. So I will again pre-do about 4 to 6 videos for that period, which are released, have timed releases, so you will still have videos of reviews or what have you over that period while we're actually moving. So there certainly won't be a break in videos. There might be slightly fewer, but there will still be videos. So anyway, thank you very much. I will start posting the other videos very soon, because there's a fair amount to catch up on. Cheers.
Tesla.co.uk